Okay? They are just saying things they want you to, they are saying things you want to hear. It is a big fat lie. Nothing is going to be done. If you should leave that street and go home, your sufferness just started. In fact, it is just doing warm up. You will never get this chance again. Buhari must go. Buhari must go. These police with the IG must go. Oshibajo must go. And when I say go, and if you don't want them to go, no wahala. Keep them up. In another few months, they will be back. And there will be no number to stop or end SARS anymore. Even the world will laugh at you because the world wants you to change it now and change it for once. So this is it. Because it is all, they are all lies. Everything in here is a lie. Everything. So don't believe it. Okay? Whatever they declared today, whatever the IG said today, my brothers and sisters, dismiss it until Boko Hari will come on the national TV and international TV to first apologize to all of you. After apologizing, then tell you that he has scrapped SARS. And we want Boko Hari to list all the names of the victims of SARS whenever I speak to you, because that's how you will know that they recorded their video. It's not from this another Muhammad Yusuf that is wearing a mask inside our Soul Rock. Are you with me? Put the live camera there. Top media houses should visit and interview Boko Hari. Then Boko Hari should list the names of the victims of SARS. In fact, Boko Hari should mention the names of those that have been killed by the Nigerian police, Nigerian SARS, in the last 24 hours, in the last 48 hours, in fact, in the last 5 days. That is when you will know that your presidiot is talking to you, okay? The lifeless, breathing mannequin is talking to you. He must mention the names of the victims. Don't use statistics to identify the victims of SARS. Then, right there in that same broadcast, Boko Hari should tell you and show you the executive order that is going to ban and scrap SARS. Again, in that same speech, Boko Hari must sack this fake criminal, this police IG. He must be sacked. So when Boko Hari finally does all that, Boko Hari needs to tell you that, in fact, his own government is doing something to make sure that SARS will never come back. Police brutality will never happen again. Harassment and assault will never happen to you again. And by law, he is sending it to the National Assembly. Listen to me, okay? They may tell you all of these are not possible because I know they are not possible too. But I like to make you feel like if they can try and do it, maybe you can begin to feel like where human beings are leading you. We know that you are not being led by human beings. You are being led by animals, cold-blooded animals, cold, stone-cold-hearted criminals, young and old. They feel nothing for you. But let's pretend that they do, that they feel something. That is the normal way you will know that they are doing something. Okay? Heads must roll. The police officers, the police IG, that order the killings, of civilians, protesting, peaceful protesters, they must be sacked. The police IG must face his own criminal charge for leading a police that is killing peaceful protesters, armless protesters. He can't just go like that. He must be sacked. You see that idiot reading something there? He was reading and I was raging. In a working country, he won't be reading you any kind of press release. He will be reading his own resignation letter. A reasonable person that has witnessed the killings of civilians, the killings of armless protesters, he should be handing over his own resignation in that video. But Nigeria is a shito country. Nigeria, as an open concentration camp, Nigeria that is running gerontocracy, the government of the older people, dead people, leading the living. Gerontocracy. That is why that madman was reading a reform that we all know that it's even, I mean, it's as worthless as the paper is written that from. If you leave that street, if you leave, sufferness, just they do a bit of a warm up. By the time it hits you, you go to say Somalia, right? You go to say Somalia and London, honestly speaking. So he must be sacked. Boko Haram himself, if he ever managed to get to you and do all this, after the police reform and all of that has been done, the entire National Assembly members should resign and go home. The entire, the state governors in Nigeria should resign and go home. I'm saying this, I know they won't, okay? Only you can sack them. And that is why they are doing this. In order for you not to sack them, in order for you not to send all the 36 governors home, all the senators, all the useless representative members, in order for you not to send them home, because they will become jobless, like many, many youth that are jobless today, okay? In order for you not to send them home, they have sent one of them to tell you that they are going to reform it. They are going to do this or that. No, they are not going to do any goddamn thing except you sack them. If you don't, on a problem, they do the answer now. He never even get ready. I'm going to be back later this evening. Okay, I needed to add this, and I'm going to show you one thing, because the people are not giving up anyway. Last night we had our brothers in Toronto, in Canada, the same message, one message, no other way than this. You get that? That's from Toronto yesterday. And they are still very much waiting. So if you are watching me from outside Nigeria, don't buy that lie. There is no ban on SARS. There is no dissolved SARS. It is just their usual gimmick. They do that all the time. This is the first time they are seeing a large mass reaction, and they are playing the same old card again. Do not listen to them. Until Boko Haram display the executive order that bans us completely, okay? Until Boko Haram himself tells you, until Boko Haram signed that, until Boko Haram forward the law, a bill into the National Assembly to say, before a policeman will arrest you, they must read you your Miranda rights. They call it Miranda. Is it Miranda law or Miranda rules or Miranda rights? Whereby police will tell you why he's arresting you. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say against you will be used. I mean, anything you say here will be used against you in the court of law. They must read you your Miranda rights. Nobody should hold you on the roadside to collect your phone and collect your money or shoot to kill you. Until Boko Haram and his handlers, until they show that sign, it is a complete ruse for you to believe that they have ended there or they are planning to end SARS. They are not.
Why?
That's our brothers in Germany, in Berlin, today. So they were protesting the end SARS protest as well in Berlin, in Germany today. So they now decided to act a scene of how it is to be, to be interrogated by SARS on the road. How SARS treats Nigerians, your Nigerian youths on the road. So these two young men decided to act. One was acting as a SARS officer. The other one was acting as a Nigerian youth. So they were now having an argument. You are Yahoo boy, give me your phone. No, why do you want my phone? So they decided to assault him and all of, he was like acting that up. Do you know what happened? A police officer who was standing by, just monitoring the protest, saw them. He thought it was real. Like, why are you beating him? They are fighting. He wanted to rush and save one of them. That is not in Nigeria. Oyibo, that didn't know that they are actually acting. He felt like, what is going on? Why are you beating him? Watch that again, so that you capture that.
Where's the phone? Why? Where's the phone?
Where's your phone?
Why
jump off the police to protect you. When police begin to attack and kill you on the street, that is not the job of the police. So in Germany, Oyinbo will even protect you because you are black. In Nigeria, a Nigerian criminal police officer will kill you because you are looking, why are you looking sweet? Why do you actually look so clean? Why do you look so fresh? Where are you from? You must be a Yahoo boy. Oh yeah, slap him, beat him. But in Nigeria, you know what they do? Everybody will just do like, now God go help us from this ass. Sisters beating people. Let me record it anyway. Let's say, Nigeria, only God will help us. So by the time you see the video, by the time they move here and there, you will see multitude witnessing the assault and the killings and the abuse on the street. In Germany, they even value us. In the UK, I am most valued. Police respect me. They regard me. My representative, my own MP, respects me. Everyone that I come across here, they show me respect. They show me respect. And you don't understand. If you don't live for where they treat you like, say, you know, be human being, and you get to where you don't even have to be anything, and you still get treated like human being, you will understand. And if you have never left Nigeria, this may not make sense to you. I get treated with respect. You don't have an idea. Until they do all I listed, Baba, we go meet for later tonight. Okay? So that's the news. That's the breaking news. SARS, they have not banned SARS. They have not dissolved SARS. They have not scrapped SARS. Everything you heard about that is complete lie. And if you buy it, Baba, 600 years. If you leave the street, she be the first one be 60 years independence, Abi. Now 600 years, you dey joke with. Or else, begin to pack your bag. If now Somalia, they give you the visa, Baba, take them all. You don't know. Maybe, you know, you don't know. I'll see you some other time.
I am a man.